Let us take a look at the instruction fetch unit. This multiplexer MA, MA stands for memory address, decides how the memory address will be passed on. If it is an instruction fetch, the address will be coming from the program counter. If it is a load instruction or a store instruction or some operands have to be fetched and the result has been generated by the ALU in stage 3, that address is available in register RZ, so that register will pass on this result to this multiplexer MA. So this memory address would either be the address from PC or some address which is coming from the interstage register RZ. When the instruction is fetched from the memory, it is placed in the instruction register. This comes via the data bus. The instruction register will hold the instruction for the complete decode execute cycle, because based on that instruction, the control circuitry will generate appropriate control signals. Also, from the bits of the instruction register, if there is any immediate value available in that, that will be extracted and sent to the multiplexer B of the data path. This we have covered earlier in one of our lessons. What happens in the instruction address generator? Let us have a look at that. In the instruction address generator, as you can see, the program counter is part of that instruction address generator. To the value of program counter, a value of 4 is added in an adder to point to the next instruction. Here I am assuming that each instruction is of 4 byte length. So if we have to go to the next instruction, if a sequential operation is being done, so the next instruction has to be executed, so program counter will be incremented by this value PC plus 4 and it will be sent back to the PC. However, if it is a branch instruction, if a branch instruction has to take place and an immediate value has to be added to the contents of the program counter, so then it will come from here. So if we have an instruction like branch to this particular offset, so this offset has to be added to the program counter. In that case, this immediate value, which is the branch offset, will be added to the program counter and will be sent back to the PC. When the PC has the new branch target address, it will fetch the next instruction from that particular target address. There is also a possibility that the program counter might be required to go to a subroutine. In that case, the address of that subroutine is going to come from the register file. So the contents of the register file will be passed on to the interstage buffer RA and then will be sent to this MUX PC. So the program counter over here will either get the value of the address of the next instruction or it will get the address of the target instruction in case it is a branch instruction, or it will get the address of the subroutine. So depending upon that, this multiplexer will choose what value has to go into the program counter. If the program counter has to go to a subroutine, it has to save the contents of the current instruction. In that case, that value will be first put into PC temp, which is another interstage register, and this will be sent to multiplexer Y to be stored in the register file in stage 5. So this is the return address for the current program where the subroutine will return. So this return address has to go into the register file in stage 5. So in the meantime, it will be stored in PC temp, which is the interstage register for the output of PC, and it will be put into the register file in the stage 5. So this is how the complete instruction address generator works and how the values are put into the program counter.